Lesson four digs into how both genes and the environment play a part in a person's risk for type 2 diabetes, and how it can be hard to tease these things apart as both genetic and cultural influences get passed on through families. So, in this lesson, students first generate a genetic risk score and then an environmental risk score. To get a genetic risk score for type 2 diabetes, students simulate their risk by drawing beans out of a bag or flipping a coin to represent 12 different allele combinations that increase or decrease their risk. Students learn about probability and how variations in hundreds, if not thousands, of genes contribute to complex diseases like type 2 diabetes. To get their environmental risk score, students fill out a survey that asks about their neighborhood's built environment and their own eating habits and activities. Students then compare their score with the thousands of people who have also taken the survey to see where they land. So the lesson takeaways for this lesson are that different allele combinations lead to variations within a population, and as with many complex conditions, hundreds of genes and hundreds of environmental factors might influence each other to determine a person's health. And both genetic and environmental factors can increase or decrease the risk for developing type 2 diabetes.